You haven't had another woman while I've been inside, have you?
Oh, no, no, I swear. I swear to God in heaven, never.
Look, I'm going to kill her if I ever find her. You little runt as you are, you're mine. Get it!
Because I am, Mon. True blue.
Yeah, well, this might help you.
No, Monty, no.
It's lucky I didn't kill him. I was ropeable.
What about the money?
Well, look, you got your key, didn't you? So stop worrying.
Yeah, but if your hubby's been running around flashing at places where he thinks people wouldn't know, I mean, how do you reckon they got hold of me?
Oh, yeah, I didn't think about that.
That money was a gift from a grateful man. What are we supposed to have done?
Hot money, Mrs. Smith. Hot money from a payroll job.
Look, a little rat named Ferguson gave me that money, and he never said anything about robberies and stuff.
He said I was a homosexual. A lesbian.
Well, love, you don't want to.
Oh, Lizzie, he said there's no hope for me.
Oh,
everyone leaves me because I'm no good for anything.
Come on, come on. You'll be all right. It has been through a bad time, that's all. You got friends. Of course you have.
Who?
You got me. You got your old Lizzie.
What are they trying to pin on you, then?
Oh, it's all stupid. They reckon I was in possession of stolen money from some payroll. Don't know nothing about it.
Well, how'd they catch up with you, then?
Oh, it's this little runty bloke. He wouldn't look twice at him, only at 8 grand. Didn't say anything about it being hot, though. I was helping him spend it, all in good faith.
Mrs. Wharton? Edith?
Mr. Fletcher?
You all right?
Oh, just a little tired, that's all.
Edith, you realise that things are going to be a bit different for you in here?
Oh, yes, Mr. Fletcher. But at least I got a decent roof over my head and a warm bed and some nice clean clothes.
No, no, I didn't mean that. I mean, you're going to have to get used to rules, regulations, people giving you orders.
Mr. Fletcher, I've never been in trouble in my life, but, well, I am now, and I'll just have to get used to it.
That's the idea. It's not going to be easy, you know.
Don't you worry about me, young man. I'm used to going to bed early and getting up early, taking orders. Well, that's going to take a bit of getting used to. I'll manage.
Well, you just keep out of trouble, do as you're told, and you can't go wrong. And if you have any problems, just come and see me, all right? Good. Have you met any of the other women yet?
No.
Weren't you at dinner?
Yes, but they didn't take any notice of me. So I thought I'd better not butt in.
Well, would you like me to take you down to the recreation room? Introduce you to some of them. Or would you rather stay here and rest?
Oh, no. Oh, I'd like that.
There you go.
Do I look all right?
You'll do. Come on.
Well, that was a pretty dumb thing to do, getting yourself caught passing stolen money.
I didn't know it was stolen, did I?
Who was this fella then who gave you the money?
Oh, some little sex star runt I've been going around with for a while. Kept promising me a good time.
Yeah, and he got you one too, didn't he? In here.
Yeah, I should have known. I was always flashing the dough around. Never knew where he got it, though. I reckon he was a professional gambler.
$8,000 is a lot to win gambling.
Oh, no, that was from the payroll snatch I was telling you about.
How do you know that?
Well, that's what the cops picked me up for. Oh, I don't think he was mixed up in it, though. Reckon he got it off his wife. That twit. She must have known it was hot. Hey, maybe you came across her. She was in here. Got out a couple of days ago. What's going on?
I asked you a question. Now, what was his name?
Let me go, that hurts!
Look, I'd tell her if you know, love, because if you don't, she'll break that arm.
You bloody great fool, that's my money she's been rabbiting on about, isn't it?
No, it's not. I told you I stashed that. It's mine. And this little bitch has been knocking off my friend and helping him to spend it.
I didn't know he was married to you.
He was married. That should have been enough.
Hey, settle
but
down,
your type don't care, do they? I'm going to...
Can I just settle down now?
Quiet! Quiet! All right, Ferguson, what's all the noise about? Back here less than a day and you're already causing trouble. All right, outside. You, wait for me outside. All right, ladies. Mrs. Edith Wharton. Oh, lovely. Yeah, that's what I'd like to see. A nice, friendly welcome.
Hello. My name's Lizzie.
I'm glad to meet you, Lizzie.
Come over here and sit down, eh?
Now, you listen to me, you little cow.
No, you listen to me for a change. First off, I didn't know Fred was married. And then when he did let it slip, well, it didn't seem to matter. As for knowing he was married to you, how the hell could I?
Look, I don't want any of your excuses. You just learn to keep your hands off married men, especially when they're mine.
You two still at it. Right, now, which one of you is going to tell me what's going on? What's the matter, Ferguson? Struck dumb all of a sudden.
I can handle this myself.
I'll bet you can. What do you got to say for yourself?
Nothing.
Passing stolen money, wasn't it?
Huh?
What you in here for?
Oh, yeah.
Where'd you get it?
A fella.
What's his name?
Dunno, just a fella.
Oh, I see. A fella whose name you can't remember just happened to give you a few $1,000s.
That's right.
And that money just happens to come from the same hall that Martin got his sticky fingers into.
Martin? I know what you're talking about. Look, I told the cops I didn't know it was stolen money. I don't know nothing about it.
Perhaps not. But it's a hell of a coincidence, isn't it, Ferguson? Wonder what else you told the police?
Nothing. I mean, I told them everything. Everything I know, that is, which is nothing.
All right, go on, get back to the recreation room. And keep your nose clean. Now, about this coincidence, Ferguson. Let's have a little chat, shall we?
So you just watch her. She can be a real bitch, that Vera.
I think I met her when I was booked in.
Yeah, but the others are not so bad. And you can get what you want in here, as long as you know the ropes and the right people. And I'm the one. I'll look after you. I always look after me mates.
Thank you, Lizzie.
You in a cell on your own?
Yes.
Yeah, well, they usually do that the first night. But I'll tell you what, though. Tomorrow, we'll try and get you moved in with Doreen and me. We got a spare bed.
I'd like that. Who's Doreen?
Oh, she's not here. She's having a bit of a kip. She's not feeling so good. You see, we've got this shrink called Clements. He's doing a scientific something or other, and he's been a bit rough on poor old Dore. She had a few problems, but she doesn't usually stay down so long. She used to bounce back. I'm real worried about her. You know what I mean? There's something wrong there.
I'm only trying to protect myself, B.
Yeah, well, throwing your weight around is not the way to do it.
Monty told me my money was safe.
Far as I know, it is.
Safe with half of Melbourne running around flashing it?
No, don't exaggerate. Besides, half of Melbourne is only flashing poor Monty's share.
How'd you know that?
How do I know what?
How'd you know it was all Monty's share?
Oh. What did you get? What did she give you?
A key.
To what?
To the safety deposit box.
Right.
But what if there's nothing in it? What if she's been conning me?
Oh, geez, look, if Monty wanted to con you out of your share, why would she go to all that trouble? I mean, she could be in Timbuktu by now. And you with another 6 months to serve. What do you say about Monty? She is not exactly bright.
What do you mean?
Nothing.
Nothing! Remember what I said. Don't you say anything. Leave all the talking to me.
What are you two skulking around for?
Waiting to see you, Miss Bennett.
What about?
Well, I was just saying to Edith here, if you want anything done in this place, just ask Miss Bennett.
Cut the soft soap, Lizzie. What do you want to see me about?
Well, we was wondering, seeing that Edith's in a room on her own and now that Lenny's gone, we've got a spare bed, if she could move in with Dora and me.
What do you think this place is, Birdsworth? A boarding house? Wharton will stay in the cell that she's been allocated to. Now get back to work.
Yeah, no, hold on, you two. Miss Bennett? I don't see any harm in those two sharing a cell.
It's ridiculous. She's in for assault.
I've seen a record. There were mitigating circumstances. Now, she's been through quite a lot lately. A bit of company could be just what she needs.
Well, certainly not up to me. Changes in cell allocation are Mrs. Davidson's responsibility.
Yes, you're right, and I'm sure she'd approve. All right, Lizzie, you can help Mrs. Wharton move her things.
Oh, thank you, Mr. Fletcher.
Thank you.
Come along then, Alicia.
Don't worry, Miss Bennett. I'll clear it with the governor on my way up.
We could do with a few more hands in here today. Where's Lizzie? Doreen? Doreen?
Wharton.
Where's Lizzie?
I don't know.
And where have you been?
I've been helping Ed move her things. She's coming in with Dora and me.
Is it all right with you, love?
What?
If Ed moves in with us.
Yeah, well, now you're here. Are you going to give us a hand or not?
Oh, yeah, B. Of course we have.
And where's Mon?
Probably murdering that Crabtree. That is not funny. It wasn't meant to be. As far as I'm concerned, I hope they kill each other.
Oh, you do you?
Yeah.
Well, no hope, Joyce.
Why?
Because I say so. If Molly as much as touches Denise, she'll end up in the pound. With her previous record, her chances of getting a parole are nil.
So what? Serve her right throwing my money around like that.
Now, listen, I'm sick of hearing about your money. It's caused enough trouble in here. And I don't want to hear another word about it. Out of you or anyone.
Not my parents.
I've got a new worker for you, Smith.
It's Bennett.
Yeah.
Does Monica Ferguson work here?
She's on guard in detail.
Why? What about after work?
What about it?
Can I be locked up in my cell after work?
What for? What are you talking about, Crabtree?
I just don't think she likes me very much.
Who? Ferguson?
Mm. Oh, you never cease to amaze me, you lot.
If you're really scared of Ferguson, I suggest you hide under your bed when she's around. She can turn nasty.
You know, I don't usually agree with Vera, but this time she's right. I'd take her advice if I were you.
Here we go. Come on, Maddie, get the ball. Quick, quick, get the ball. Get the ball. I'll get you. Hey, who got the ball? Who left the ball behind?
Nicholas, Matthew, Jim, half time.
Yeah, go on, kids. Off you go. Quick. Half time it is. Your mum's the ref.
Thanks. Sit down for a minute. Young Maddie seems to be getting taller by the minute.
Yeah, he's filling out too. Must be the swimming lessons.
Oh, that's great. Best exercise there is. He's not still afraid of the water then?
Oh, not a bit. Swims like a fish.
Yeah.
Or tadpole anyway. Kids are funny, aren't they?
Yeah.
Remember how Nicky took to the water? Couldn't get him out until he was all blue and shriveled up. Seems to have lost interest now.
Really?
Well, that's not exactly true. He still likes it. But he's got this thing about gymnastics now.
Gymnastics?
He's quite good at it too. Came home the other day chattering about winning 2 gold stars on the parallel bars or something.
You're doing a good job, Lee.
Oh, they're good kids.
Yeah. How's the job?
Oh, you know, good.
Novelty hasn't worn off, then?
That's not fair, Jim. You know I didn't get the job just for the hell of it.
Yeah, well, I didn't mean it like that. It's just that you were so keen on it when you started. I was wondering whether, you know, well, if you're getting bored.
Well, not bored. But the novelty has worn off, as you put it. But the money's even more important now.
It needn't be.
Oh, don't.
Don't what?
Don't start that again. And don't look so hurt. You know, if you got back together again, we couldn't live on just your salary.
Oh, come on, it's not that bad.
Oh, it is. It always has been.
You're exaggerating.
I'm not. Oh, we've been through this conversation how many times? Look, I know I'm being selfish, but I want the best for the kids. And for me, too.
No, you're just afraid of becoming the bored housewife.
Oh, that's not true, Jim. Not entirely. Look, I know you. If we got back together again, you'd want me to give up my job in 2 weeks.
Well, we could manage.
Well, we couldn't. We're better off now with 2 incomes. You just won't admit it. You think I'm doing this for some women's lib thing? You think that my independence is a threat to your manhood? Oh, I don't know. But it's not like that. If we could live on your salary and live the way I want us to live, I'd give up right now.
So it all boils down to the money, then? I miss them, Lee.
I know.
Hard work out here. I'm damned if I know what Lynn Warner saw in it. Break their bats if it could.
Well, what are you doing out here anyway?
Oh, Fletcher's idea.
Get rid of some of that aggro out of your system, eh? Good idea.
Maybe. You know, I reckon he's onto me. About the money, I mean.
Oh,
now listen. Look, he
We're on and on and on about it last night.
Don't tell me you broke down and confessed.
Oh, look, B, I'm not joking. He told me the Crabtree dobbed Fred into the cops.
Well, you know she did. Otherwise, why would the cops be asking questions?
Yeah, but how does he know?
Oh, don't be thick, Monty. It wouldn't be difficult for him to find out.
Well, that bloody woman's fault. If I get my hands on that conniving hussy, I'll wring her bloody neck.
Oh, now, look, knocking her around's not going to solve anything.
Yeah, well, maybe not, but it'll make me feel good.
Yeah, and land you in the pound for God knows how.
Oh, look, whose side are you on?
Oh, yours, you thick twit, only you're too dumb to realise it. Look, it doesn't matter what Fletch thinks he knows. He can't prove anything. And nor can the cops, unless they find out where the money is. And who's going to tell them that?
Yeah, well, I just don't like tarts getting off with my hubby getting away with it.
Oh, God.
You, she'd just better stay out of my way. That's all I can say.
I'd really like to stay a little bit longer, but I've got to be back at work in half an hour.
You're still pretty damp.
Oh, yeah. Buddy kids, they can't take a bath by themselves. It's been a good day.
Yeah.
Well, can I see you all next week?
All right.
Thanks, Lee.
Do you want a game of cards, Molly?
Yeah, it's a good idea. Let's go to the loo first.
Okay.
Oh, sorry, did I scare you?
Nah. Thought I'd come and see if you want to have a game of cards or something.
No, thanks.
Look, if you're worried about Moni, she won't be there.
Why not?
Screws have locked her up in her cell.
Why?
Because last night's blue, I suppose. She's got a rotten reputation, Moni, always causing trouble.
Why didn't that Miss Bennett say something to me this morning?
I don't know. Perhaps she didn't know. It was probably Fletcher's idea. You know he hates Moni's guts. You should have seen Moni when she found out. Kicked up a hell of a stink. But they wouldn't listen. They marched her out there and then.
I just saw her before in the corridor.
Well, it was just after that had happened, actually. That's why I thought you knew.
Nah.
Well, if you don't feel like it.
Hang on.
Hey, Doreen, you want to get my cards?
That's great. I wish I could have seen the bitch's face. Hey, Dor, do you know what she did? She got stuck into a landlady with an umbrella. Wham, wham.
I don't think I hurt her.
Oh, you should have killed her, treating you like that. Oh, I wish I could have seen it, though. I like a good scratch.
Lizzie, you all right?
Yes, love, I'm all right. I got a weak ticker.
Is it bad?
Oh, yes, pretty bad. But Doc Miller makes me take it easy. You met him yet?
Yes.
Yeah, of course, on the first night. But you see, I've been in here so long, I forget what's going on sometimes. Oh, yes, he is a nice young fella. Bit soft, though, but nice young fella. He's always fussing about me working too hard. But I'm a tough old bird and take more than a week ticket to finish me off, wouldn't it, Dor? But it comes in useful sometimes, eh, Dor? Oh, now, love, don't look like that. I didn't mean nothing. It's just that it comes in very handy sometimes because you can put on a bigger an act and they're frightened that you might snuff it, you know. Have you got anything wrong with you?
What are you doing in here?
She wants to play cards.
I suppose this is your idea of a joke, Joyce.
I don't know what you mean.
I bet. I'd get out of here if I was you before Moni arrives.
Monica? You told me she was locked in her cell.
Yeah, go on, skedaddle. I'll deal with her.
Not so fast.
I've got a bone to pick with you.
Now, steady on, Monnie.
Keep out of this, Bee.
Look, this is not going to do you any good.
Look, just rack off, Bee. My beef with her, not with you.
Yeah, all right. Go on, end up in the pound, you
Hey, give it to her, Monnie. Oh, Lizzie, are you all right?
Oh, cut it out, Lizzie. It's not funny anymore.
Stop me. Oh, is it your heart, Lizzie?
My pill.
A bit of luck.
Now, come, what are you all gawping at? It's just Lizzie going to another one of her turns again. She'll be racing back in here a minute, laughing her head off at how she's fooled you all. Now, come on, Monnie, play cards.
Hey, you. Keep an eye out for the screws.
I want to see how Lizzie is.
We're nearly there, Lizzie. We're nearly there.
What's all this? Charades.
Oh, Miss Bennett, it's Lizzie's heart. She's had another attack. We've got to get her to the doctor quickly.
I'll pull the other one, Anderson. What little scheme are you two trying to cover up this time?
Oh, but it's true, Miss Bennett, honest.
I should have known. I'll deal with you two later.
No,
come on.
No. Oh, you bloody morons! Come on,
Don't worry, Lizzie. I'm here. I'm gonna look after you.
Is she going to be all right?
I don't know.
Have you given her the pills?
Yeah, but they don't seem to be working. Something must be really wrong.
Have you called a doctor?
No, I can't leave her. She might die, and I won't be here. Oh, don't worry, Lizzie. Don't worry. Door's here.
How dare you wet fish! The bloody fish! She's not even a man eating more hungry! Madam! I'm gonna ruin her pretty looks for her, you wait and see now that's gonna stop me!
Let's help me! Lizzie's dying!
What'd you say?
I think Lizzie's dying.
You don't have to worry about Lizzie. She's well known for her fake attacks.
It's true, I swear it. I wouldn't lie to you, Mr. Fletcher.
Yeah, well, she had a turn just now. I thought she was faking. She must have been for real.
We want your opinion, Ferguson. We'll ask for it. Believe me, she's faking.
Look, Mr. Fletcher, I'll be okay now, I promise. Please, just say to Lizzie.
All right, I'll take Ferguson to the pound. Go and get Dr. Miller.
He's gone home ages ago.
Then ring him.
This is another stunt of Lizzie's.
Oh, gee, she's a hard cow.
Yeah, come on, Ferguson, come on.
Is that better, Lizzie? Gotta keep you warm. Oh, wake up, Lizzie. Please. Don't you die on me, too. I couldn't bear that. Not to lose you as well. I don't want to be left alone. Oh, please. Please don't die. Oh, don't die, Lizzie. Please.
You finished?
Yes.
Good. How is she?
Which one?
Lizzie, of course.
Well, was touch and go there for a while, but she got to her pills just in time. No thanks to a certain member of staff, so I understand. Seen some callous behaviour in my time, but Vera takes some beating.
No, I don't think you can blame Miss Bennett. Lizzie's well known for tricks.
I believe she's even managed to con you a couple of times. Yeah. No, she's only got herself to blame. She keeps crying wolf. She can't complain if no one takes any notice of her.
No, I guess you're right. I tend to ignore her myself these days. Trouble is, we're all too used to her tricks. She'd be better off in hospital.
Well, do you want me to ring an ambulance? Or have you already done that?
Well, better to let her rest tonight, I think. If we could arrange that in the morning, and maybe you could get somebody to keep an eye on her for me.
Oh, yeah, of course. Well, thanks for coming in.
Well, it's part of the job. Oh, Denise Crabtree would be okay.
There was a lot of blood.
Yes, more of that than actual damage. A few superficial cuts and a bloody nose. She'll look a bit bruised and battered for a couple of days, but she'll be okay.
Good.
Wish I could say the same about Lizzie.
Why? You said she was all right.
Yes, this time, but at her age and in her condition, next attack could very well kill her.
Edith, you awake?
Yes. Can't you sleep?
No. I keep thinking about Lizzie. Do you think she's gonna die? Do you?
I don't know, Doreen. When you're our age, mine and Lizzie's, it don't take much. When you're our age.
I don't want her to die.
People do. You don't want them to die. They do.
Vera, could you arrange to have Lizzie transferred to hospital first thing in the morning?
Are you serious?
Well, of course I'm serious. Why shouldn't I be?
Lizzie Birdsworth has already made one attempt to escape. And you know what happened when B. Smith went to hospital?
Lizzie is in no fit state to try to escape. In fact, she wouldn't be as sick as she is if the help she needed had been forthcoming.
Well, don't try blaming that on me.
I'm not. That doesn't alter the fact that Lizzie is very ill and we're short-staffed. She'll be better off in hospital. You agree with me, don't you, Jim?
He hasn't the authority to transfer her. Only Mrs. Davidson has that.
Miss Bennett, you of all people should know that during the governor's absence, I do have that authority. However, since the doctor's request isn't urgent, we'll put it to Mrs. Davidson in the morning and then we'll see what happens, all right? Good night, doctor.
Good night.
Good heavens, what is this, a deputation?
I'm afraid Lizzie had another attack last night.
Oh dear, how is she?
She's resting quite calmly.
Well, that's something.
Yes, but I would like to have her sent to hospital.
Mrs. Davidson, I've already pointed out to Dr. Miller how dangerous that could be. We've had one escape from a hospital, and Lizzie's tried it once before.
Well, that's true. Dr. Miller, does Lizzie's condition really warrant hospitalization?
Well, that's hard to say. At the moment, she's fine, but if she does have another attack...
At the moment, she's not on the critical list. Is that what you're saying?
At the moment, no, but...
Then I think she should stay here. I'm sure she will get adequate care.
Whatever you say, Mrs. Davidson. I'll go and check on her and make sure she's allowed complete peace and quiet.
Don't see why we even bother to have a doctor if we don't take his advice.
He said her condition wasn't serious. He'd be much better looking after his other patient instead of telling Mrs. Davidson how to do her job.
What other patient?
Oh, didn't Mr. Fletcher tell you? There was a brawl in the recreation room last night.
Damn. Well, you'd better tell me all about it.
Well, Doreen, what's the matter with you? Bit early for sick call, aren't you?
I just want to see how Lizzie is.
Yeah. I'm glad someone's concerned with their welfare. You sure you're all right? Don't look too well to me.
I'm okay.
I think I'd better take a look at you.
I'm fine. Honest. I just want to see how she is.
Doreen, Liz is an old lady and a very sick one at the moment. I think it'd be better if we just left her...
Oh, but can I see her? She's the only friend I've got left. Please.
Yes, well, I don't see why not.
Oh, thanks, Doc.
On one condition.
Yeah?
That you let me examine you first. It'll only take a moment.
Okay.
Good. Well, go behind the screen and get yourself ready.
check on Ferguson.
Morning.
Morning.
Late night, Vera?
Oh, yeah, but not the sort you mean.
Oh?
Ferguson and that Crabtree woman had a fight in the recreation room. Ferguson beat the hell out of the other one and we had to put her in the pound.
I thought Jim Fletcher was on night shift.
Oh, fat lot of good he was.
Well, why?
I don't know, really. He took one look at the Crabtree woman's bashed up face and, well, he just froze. It wasn't until I yelled at him for help that he did anything.
What do you mean?
Well, he just stood there.
Morning, ladies.
Morning.
Morning, Dr. Clements.
You bitch.
What's the matter with you?
Don't come a bloody innocent with me. You set me up last night.
I don't know what you're talking about. Get lost.
You know what I'm talking about.
I'm warning you. Get lost or I'll thump you.
Oh, no, you won't.
She's not talking to me like that.
Cool it.
Get knotted.
I'm the boss here, and I say there's been enough brawling, and I'm fed up with it.
If you so much as lay a finger on her, I'll give you a set of bruises to go with the one she's got.
It's not fair, B. The bitch shouldn't get away with
it. Oh, and who said she's going to? I know all about Joycey. Don't I, Joycey? Just simmer down, kid. I'll deal with her in my own way.
You all make me sick!
Now, what's got into you?
You lot, bitching and round while poor old Lizzie could be dead for all you know. And what the hell do any of you care? A big, fat nothing. All you're worried about is your peddling little arguments.
Well, now, calm down, Doreen. It's not our fault that Lizzie's really had a heart attack this time.
Yes, it is. You're all to blame, especially that stinking great mate of yours, Monica Ferguson.
Now, what started all that?
See the doctor, don't you? Hey, hey. There, there. Hey, you're going to be all right. Everything's going to be fine.
You ought to watch her, Mrs. Jackson. I reckon she's around the bend.
Mind if I have a cup?
No, help yourself.
Keeping you busy?
Yeah.
I heard you were on duty last night.
So?
Nothing. You just seem to be putting in a lot of hours.
Mm. I suppose the money's useful.
Yeah, if you ever get a chance to spend it.
Pity about old Lizzie.
Yeah.
I don't know how anyone can stand it in here.
They haven't got much choice, have they?
I didn't mean the prisoners. I meant the staff. Why do you do it?
Somebody's got to do it.
Yeah, but why you? I mean, well, what do your family think about you working in here?
Look, do you mind? I mean, I'm busy. Some other time, huh?
Sorry, just passing the time of day.
More trouble, I'm afraid.
Oh, God, what is it now?
It's Doreen Anderson. She's gone crazy. Tried to attack Monica Ferguson.
I thought Ferguson was in solitary.
Well, she is. She tried to grab her through the bars.
Well, where's Doreen now?
Well, I managed to calm her down. I've taken her back to her cell.
Right, well, get Dr. Miller to have a look at her. I'll tell Mrs. Davidson.
Right.
Mrs. Jackson, did you leave this here?
No, what is it?
Probably nothing.
Doreen, are you all right? It's me, Edith.
Excuse me. Doreen? Doreen? It's very interesting. A perfect example of retrogressive withdrawal.
Hey?
Doreen, can you hear me?
Excuse me, Peter, if you don't mind.
Doreen, it's Dr. Miller. Can you hear me, Doreen?
I don't think you should be here, Doctor.
I would have thought I was better qualified than anybody. Besides, she's one of my subjects.
She's not a guinea pig.
You don't have to whisper. She can't hear you.
Is she going to be all right?
Shh, Edith. What do you think, Greg?
There's nothing I can do. She needs a psychiatrist. She should be in hospital.
Why not leave her here? We could keep her under observation.
I thought I told you to leave.
Now, look.
Now, either you leave or I'll report you to the governor.
Greg, perhaps we can discuss this case later.
Yes.
What are we going to do?
Talk to Mrs. Davidson. Just hope she doesn't try to keep Doreen here like she did Lizzie. Now keep an eye on her, would you?
Right. Never rains but it pours. Who's with Doreen now?
Dr. Miller.
Well, there's nothing much I can do until I get his report.
Right. There is another matter.
Well, you'd better tell me now while I can still take it.
I found it in the staff room.
Do you think it's genuine?
Yes, I do.
Well, what do you think's in the deposit box?
Obviously the proceeds of the robbery that Martin's husband was involved in.
Well, that's a pretty big assumption. I mean, it could be someone trying to cause trouble. There's been a lot of unrest amongst the women lately.
Well, that's precisely why I think it's genuine. What else would they be fighting about?
Believe me, it doesn't take much. Very well. We'll organise a search of Martin's cell. But Martin had better be there just in case we find something.
Right.
We don't want her claiming that we planted the key on her.
Okay, I'll take care of it myself. No, Doctor.
Oh, Dr. Miller, how's Doreen?
Pretty bad, I'm afraid. She seems to have withdrawn completely. She needs to be transferred to a psychiatric hospital.
Oh. Well, I'll make the arrangements.
Then you don't object?
Well, why should I?
Dr. Clements seemed to think that she should be kept here for observation.
Dr. Clements is here to do research, not to tell me how to run the prison. Would you help Dr. Miller take Doreen out, Mr. Fletcher? I'm afraid the search will have to wait.
Right. Come on, Doctor. Now leave it, Jim.
Now, Doreen, what you been up to?
I'm going away for a while, Bea. If you see Lizzie, will you tell her I'll be back real soon?
Of course I will.
Bye, Bea.
Bye, kiddo. Take care.
Now the rest of you get back to work. You heard, Smith. Get a move on.
Watch it, Vera. I'm in just the mood for you today.
You're the one who's going to have to watch it. Any more cheek and you'll end up in solitary too.
I would just love to see you try and put me in there, Vera.
No idea she was so close to cracking up.
You never do with things like that, Bea.
Oh, she's been a bloody pain in the neck lately, but I didn't think she was sick.
Do you think the doctor would let me see Lizzie?
Oh, I don't see why not. What you going to ask him?
Hey, where do you think you're going?
To see Lizzie.
And leaving me to do all this on my own? Come on, get back here.
Off you go, Edie.
You just love throwing your weight around, don't you?
You want to make anything of it? No, I didn't think so. Shoving little old ladies around and getting people stuck in solitary, that's more your go, isn't it?
Look, why don't you stop picking on me? If you're going to thump me, then get it over with.
No, I'm not going to thump you, love. I've got something much better in mind for you.
What do you mean?
Oh, you'll see.
Hello, Edith. Where are you off to?
I'm going to see Lizzie. Oh, poor old love. She's probably lonely.
You really care about people, don't you, Edith?
I've looked after people all my life. Mind you, I don't know what I'd do with myself if I didn't have someone to fuss over.
Well, that's the way it goes sometimes.
Doreen, she's gone.
Yeah.
Poor kid. I'll miss her. Do you realise I've only been in here a couple of days And I'm back in a cell by myself again.
I know. Can't be helped. But I doubt if it'll be for long. Tell me, Edith, how is it that someone like you ends up in a place like this?
I might ask you the same thing, eh? Tell you the truth, Mr. Fletcher, I'm not so sure myself. A friend of mine died suddenly. I guess I felt lost and lonely. Didn't seem to be able to get by. It's as simple as that.
Still seems a bit hard putting a woman like you in this place.
Things would have been different if you'd been the magistrate, eh?
You think I'd let you off, do you, huh?
You're a gentleman, Mr. Fletcher. You wouldn't have let them put me in here. Mind you, if I wasn't here, don't know where I'd be.
No, I'm sure to be someplace better than this, Evie.
I'm not.
Ready for the search, Mr. Fletcher?
Hmm? Oh, yeah, yeah. See you later, Edith.
I'll be here.
Martin? Come with me, please. I'm about to have your cell searched.
Why me?
You heard Mrs. Davidson outside.
What do you think that's all about, B?
How should I know?
Somebody tell me what this is all about.
I'm sure you know.
I don't.
Oh, you don't expect me to believe that, do you, Martin?
It's up to you, isn't it?
Watch your mouth, Martin. Why don't you do yourself a favour? Tell us the truth.
All right, carry on, Mr. Fletcher. You really surprise me, Martin. Didn't you realise the last person you should trust was Monica Ferguson?
I don't know what you're talking about.
I think you do. But if you imagine you can get away with it, you're a bigger fool than I thought. You're in enough trouble as it is. If you give us the key.
Okay.
The key to the safety deposit box.
I got nothing to say.
All right, have it your own way, but you'll end up the loser.
Nothing.
Right. This isn't the last you'll hear of this. I believe you do know something. And I promise you, if there is a key, we'll find it.
You two-timing bitch!
Watch it.
You got me in, you cow.
Oh, what are you rabbiting on about?
You told Jim Fletcher about my key.
Now you call me a lagger as well as a bitch.
Say it again and I'll bust your mouth.
Threatening me won't change things. You told him about it and then you pinched it.
Don't be stupid.
Then who did? Jim Fletcher just searched my cell and he didn't find anything. After he'd gone, I looked where I'd hidden it. It wasn't there. Now, apart from Monnie, you're the only one who even knew I had a key. She's in solitary, so it must have been you.
And what about Jim Fletcher? Maybe he did find it. And maybe he intends keeping it for himself.
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside. And things were different then. The sun still shines and the rain falls down, but the sun and rain are prisoners too when morning comes around. Last night I dreamed we were together, sharing all the love we'd known. Face the nightmare, awaken up alone. On the inside the roses grow, they don't mind the stony ground, but the roses here are prisoners too when morning comes around.